Welcome back, Clashers. Today I'm going to do something slightly different from my other videos. It's not going to be about farming, but we're going to have a look at a few easy Town Hall 11 war attack strategies. Mainly, the army composition we're going to look at consists of golems, bowlers, and witches, and in some cases, even a few healers. I'd also like to show you one base in particular that I think everyone needs to stop using because it is so easy to defeat if you know how to attack it, and I'm pretty sure by now this strategy is quite well known. Anyway, so let's have a look at the attacks. This war, most of us are max Town Hall 11, and if they're not maxed, maybe they're missing a few hero levels or the wall isn't completely maxed, but the majority are max Town Hall 11 bases. So let's have a look at this this attack done by Simon. It's an absolute brilliant attack, really. It's very easy to use, and depending on how you plan it, and what bases, some bases are better for this and some bases are worse. It depends on how you make it work with the jump spells or earthquake spells. You can use either of them, but the idea is that you start from, Simon's going to start from 12 o'clock to 3 o'clock, and attack the base like a wave through the base. You're going to create three groups. One middle group, obviously, that goes through the base, and then you have the two flanks going on the sides. And if you see here, he's going to start with his witches, four on each side in each corner, and a couple of bowlers to kind of create a funnel for the main group. But also, you want a couple of you want a smaller group to go along the side to kind of clear the side for you. And since the bowler and witch combo is such a great combo, I mean, both of them are ranged, and the witches provide perfect defense for the group with all the skeletons. So you see he enters through the base and hitting the Inferno Tower first, and then he's gonna drop a poison spell on the Clan Castle troops. And the Grand Warden ability was used quite late, but then again there were no giant bombs around there except in the beginning, and I'm not sure if the bowlers were there or if the golems were tanking, because he uses two golems to tank. When you plan these attacks, you want to figure out a way to lead your main army in a path going through both Inferno Towers and the Eagle Artillery using your jumps and earthquake spells. And you can see here, it places jumps perfectly to create such a path, even including the town hall in this path, to make sure that the second star is secured in case the army runs out of gas before the last defense building is down. And he managed to do that. It was quite beautiful to watch. You can see he has his Archer Queen left, which is nice, and these skeletons are just tanking everything. So that was a great attack by Simon, very nice. Next up, we have a similar attack done by Beaven. And I'm not sure from what side he attacks. He attacks from the same side. And it's the same thing here. He uses witches in the corners and a wave of bowlers. He has his giants tanking in the middle, and then heroes and Clan Castle with more bowlers. And he plans the attack so that his main group, the middle group, walks through the Inferno Towers and the Eagle Artillery. Which is quite nice, and you use the Rage Spell where it's needed, preferably for the first Inferno Tower and the second Inferno Tower, because obviously when they start attacking, every second counts. And you can see in this attack, I mean, it's almost completely destroyed this base, and his heroes are still full health, and he has his queen ability left. I mean, there's nothing that can stop this attack now. There are only two defenses left, Tesla and a wizard tower, and they're not going to be able to do much. I'm going to speed this up. Beautifully done. Very nice. This third attack I'm going to show you is done by Skiable. And he uses earthquake spells instead. And the thing is, if you can manage to open up... let's pause before the walls break. If you can manage to open up a path through both Inferno Towers and the Eagle Artillery using four earthquake spells and a jump spell, these are only two places rather than three if you bring three jump spells. If you can manage to open it up with the earthquake spells, then it might be better to use earthquake spells because the diameter is bigger, and then maybe you can take an advantage of this. And obviously he does that. He opens up quite a lot of sections here with the earthquakes. So, and then he's going to use the jump spell to open the first two layers. And same thing here, he uses, but he deploys his golems first and then the witches. But I mean, if the deployment area is far enough from any defenses, then you can just go ahead and deploy them, because they're going to spawn, the witches are going to spawn their skeletons before they take damage anyway. If the base is closer to the edge, then you should deploy the golems first, because then they'll tank and you won't lose your witches early in the attack. And I mean, it's quite straightforward, this attack. There's really not that much to it. The concept is the same. You have a main army going through the base while you have two groups on the flanks clearing the sides. And I mean, it's all about the initial planning. You want to plan it so that you enter through the correct side and that you have a clear path through and really reaching that second Inferno Tower. That's very important, because I mean, one Inferno Tower can be devastating to any witches and bowlers that are still alive, because it's going to melt the skeletons so fast they're not going to be able to provide any defense for the bowlers and witches that are still alive. Unless you have your Archer Queen left and her ability or something like that. But that's an important aspect of it. You really have to plan it so that you reach that second Inferno Tower. Alright, so that's it. Well done. Very nice attack. Alright, so the last attack I'm going to show you is this. This was actually done by me. This base. I mean, there are a lot of variations on this base. The most common one is a bit more oblong than this one is. This one is kind of more circular. But it's a donut base, obviously, and it doesn't really matter how you place your defenses. These bases are so easy because there's a concept of attacking this base. There's a strategy that once you learn how to do it, there's just a few steps that you have to do right. Then basically the concept of attacking is just, it's going to defeat this base in most of the times. What I do here is I use a queen walk, and preferably I will enter to kill the Eagle Artillery early up, because if I do that, then I can deploy the Bane army and it's not going to damage them, obviously. But you can choose from two entry points here. Either you go for the Eagle Artillery or you go for the Clan Castle. I chose the Eagle Artillery, and I don't want to go straight on it, because usually they have placed some air bombs or seeking air mines just outside, because they know how this base is attacked. But and I went in from the side with my queen walk, but I was really stupid here, because I used my funnel baby dragon where I wasn't supposed to deploy any air troops, so I had to use my second one, which I originally intended to use here below, to kind of cut off, because it's the most important thing here is that you actually get the queen to walk inside. So you want to clear buildings on the outside. I used a rage spell quite early because I wanted to rage the wall breakers as well, making sure they actually reached the wall. And then once she enters, it's just a matter of reaching that Eagle Artillery. Once she destroys it, you're free to deploy your main army, which is going to be basically everything except the Valkyries. And obviously she's going to choose a direction around the base. So you have to wait for her to do that. She's either going to walk clockwise or counterclockwise. So my queen decided to go clockwise, so I deploy my army here. Bowlers and witches, more clan castle bowlers, and then wall breakers to open up the wall. And then the queen walk and the main army join up, and they go around the whole base, clearing everything, except for this inner compartment. And I mean, this attack strategy isn't new at all. I mean, it's been around for a long time. I think the first time I saw it was Clashing with Ashe, or Clash with Ashe, or someone else, I can't remember. But you send your Valkyries, once you have cleared like 180 degrees, you send your Valkyries with a jump spell to the core and you rage them. They take care of the town hall and the most importantly the Inferno Towers, if you aim to 3-star. And once they are destroyed, then this army, I mean, it's kind of unstoppable. Because you're always going to have your skeletons in front. And yes, bomb towers, wizard towers, mortars, they can kill them all in one shot, but the witches are going to keep spawning new ones. And I had a rage spell to spare, so I used it here to kind of speed up the process. And the Valkyries missed one Tesla tower in the middle, so they're going to have to fight through the wall to kill that last Tesla tower. But yeah, that's it. That's how you defeat this base. And I mean, this attack strategy really is well known. It's been out there for a long time, and it's actually not just designed to beat these specific bases, but any ring base really. But these ones are I mean, they're too easy. So my advice, or what I wanted to tell everyone, is just stop using this base because it's not a viable Town Hall 11 war base. It really isn't. I mean, if you're in like a 20 versus 20 or more Town Hall 11 war, there's going to be at least two or three players that knows how to do this, and it's just a waste, really. I mean, you're essentially giving away a 3-star for free. So yeah, avoid using this base at all costs. All right, guys, I'm gonna wrap this up here. I hope you found the text interesting, and if you haven't tried them before, you really should give them a go. Even if you're Town Hall 10, they still work like a charm. These attacks are all about planning, really. If you plan them perfectly, the execution itself isn't that complicated. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed, and thank you for watching.